Hello guys and welcome to episode 36 on Coldborough Park Farm. Now, I have finished drilling, well almost finished. I've drilled, well, I'll have a look on the map. Drilled 7, 17, 9, 2, 4, 3, 5, and I've just got to do this last little bit on 6. So, let's carry on with this. Now, quite a lot of you probably be wondering, why am I not using cosplay anymore to do it? Well, it kind of got annoying. So that's why I'm using auto tractor instead. I set both of these tractors off. Doing same job of drilling. And they both did it fine with auto tractor. So set one off at different corners of the field. What's this? Cosplay kind of started to mess itself up a bit, so I'm not using that anymore. I may only use it for biogas stuff, but none of this stuff. So what I'm gonna do now is we do have this seed drill for a bit longer, but there's no other fields that I can drill that I own. So I'm gonna wash this equipment down, then probably return it. Because don't want to keep it for too long, so don't need it. So we can return it. Maybe get some money back, I think. That might be how it works. This tractor is really messy. Dirty. It's really muddy. So I hope you guys also enjoyed the Euro truck that's been going on this week. And I've also got a serious question. Do you guys want to see a change in map? Because I have kind of noticed there's not been as many views on the latest episodes of these as I kind of would have liked. Not getting as popular. So would you guys want to see a change of map? Old Ridge will be carrying on in July because I'm off on holiday, so can't record. So Old Ridge will basically try to finish off that series in July. The quality is not the best because when I was recording that series a couple of months ago, I didn't have the quality set to the highest, so that's the reason why. And we also better return this, so sell that. That's going to be a bit of a problem. It probably makes sense to actually connect it up to the tractor so I know I've got rid of the correct one. That's the correct one being returned, and hopefully that other tractor, the other fast track, may have finished the field, which in that case I actually forgot as well, I turned off plant growth, so I'll put it onto normal. But here we are, we've finished doing this field now. It's going to be quite a good harvest this year, I think. Or this time around anyway, because we have that huge field 17 that we're just going to be doing wheat, and we will actually get some bales from it. I'll bale the whole field because it's easier. But those two, what is it? Eight is the one straight ahead. Six and seven, they will be done whole crop harvesting, so we can put them into the biogas power. I think it's a power anyway, or heating, whichever one is closest to us. Put it in that silage pit. Oh, it looks as if we did get some money back. Well, we've got some money from somewhere, you can see. I've also downloaded the free DLC. I'm not going to get the other DLC. I don't really want it. The Chrome Big X will do fine for me. But I may get the wheeled loader from that big loader. But I'll probably, I don't know, I might get it from that. Might buy it on here and use it for biogas. But the JCB, I'm looking at the JCB because that will be the one that I'll probably get. Because it's, I think it's bigger than the New Holland wheeled loader. There's also a New Holland fixed boom one. Telehandler. And I think that was it that came in the loaders pack. So, what do we have to do on here now? That's the question. Right, so we've got these parks down here at this farm. We'll have to move that wall pallet so another one can spawn. Probably do with, I don't know, I want to see if these bales are still pretty decent. Hay bales, and then these straw bales, okay. And remember, I put, did I? I don't know, I think I may have done some straw blowing at some point maybe. I don't actually know. But I did also sell some of the milk. So we got some money for that. Which was good. It's a good trailer this as well. I pulled it behind the Unimog. But what I'll do now is just get that pallet off of that trigger. Probably sell these now, so I'm going to use for them. You can't put them back on the trigger, I don't think, and make them get more wool on them. Bit of a pain, but yes. What I was thinking was getting the Unimog and kind of put, chuck them in the back of there and go down and sell them. That may work. Hope it does. These pallets are huge. Looks as if that's not an option. I have to do two trips. I actually be able to fit both of these pallets on here? Hope I can. Hope they just stay on, don't fall off. Falls off. Oh well. Right, F1. Attach. Because I just have to be careful how I drive. Be careful, is what it looks like I'll have to do. And the multiplayer Monday is starting on Monday. And we will be going to Budapest around that area, so Hungary. And probably go through Bratislava. Because if I can't find a load that goes straight to Budapest, it'd be Bratislava that I have to go to. But I don't know what we can really do this episode. Stuck with things. Sorry about that. Yeah, a bit stuck on things to do. So let's find. Basically, what I want is all of the crops to grow as much as they will, and then we can harvest. Probably do a bit first, but spreading. Some point. But yes. Can I see this pallet just falling straight off if we don't get to this sell point quickly? Bit of a pain in the sell point. So we got 140 quid and 158 pounds for them. The back off, there we go. Let's fly down these roads. But I did use this for fertilizer spreading. It works really well. And I enjoyed using it for fertilizer spreading. So it's a nice thing to drive. And to crash, so you go in there. And he showed them how to drive. A bit reckless there, whoops. Oh, this field here, we're looking at buying it, because we can get a fair few grass bales out here, and also silage kind of things. £22,700. It's okay. It's a good field though, as you can see. Just jump on the back of here. Yeah, it's a decent sized field. So probably at some point we'll end up buying this. So it's for doing grass bale, hay bale, sorry. And then maybe wraps bales. So I'm looking at hiring the wrapper for round bales. And the round baler. So then we have like silage bales. Also, we've got sheep in that field, and cows there. Take a look around here. We do have this water pump, which is good. Could they do with a bit more? Does it tell you on here? No. I don't know. Might try to do is find like a really small mower and just go around the cow field and this is the sheep field. Or even the mower to do these bits because they are a bit annoying. I want something like that ride-on lawnmower that was in FS13. May even try to find a mod for that for the next episode. Or even actually, guys, just hang on here and I will be back with that mower mod. Hi guys, I'm back. So I've bought it already. And I will go to the Coldborough Farm, pick up the little trailer, the load trail, and then go collect my new lawnmower. So this, I'm gonna do some of the mowing around the farm. It's got the mower has a top speed of 8 miles an hour, and got a beacon. Basically, what I read, it's a converted because the mower in FS13, a little ride-on, is the same one as that, and I think it's they just say it's just been converted over. So you can use it in FS15, which is good because that was a brilliant mower. Now this Land Rover's got really slidey so far since patch 1.3. It's got a bit more slidey than usual. Be a bit careful. Right. Move that fast track out there. This little load trailer. It's a bit big for just the lawnmower, but it works fine. What I've been using since I downloaded it, it's good. It's mainly for America, because I believe that kind of trailer is popular in America with that white and red stripe pretty line on the bottom of the trailer. And it, I think, number plate isn't British, I'll put it that way. I don't even think this has a number plate either. No, it doesn't. But the Land Rover works fine for this kind of stuff. Just moving different items from farm to farm and from the shop. So it's good. So left here, there is my lawnmower. I've already driven around in it a bit, slightly just around this car park to make sure it actually works. The question is actually, I didn't check if it fits on the trailer, if the wheels actually manage to get onto the trailer itself. So that will be interesting. Yep, does. So we could fit a couple of lawnmowers on here. Actually, I've had the idea of buying a quad bike. And I change the colour on a quad bike. Is that one, the tracks one. Now I would go for that one, but it's a bit unrealistic for this farm, so I'm going to go for this Can-Am one. Buy that, then we can stick that onto trailer as well whilst we're down here, because this I can pull small trailers on here, just do some stuff on this quad bike, and it's good as well. It's a nice quad. Stick it on the back of this trailer here. In fact, just nudge this forward slightly. Just got a trailer full of toys. Question is, can the Land Rover cope? Probably can. As you can see there, suspension's a bit low at the back and quite high at the front. Probably makes sense as well to lock the load so it doesn't come flying off if we go around a corner. The thing is, you can overtake with this trailer just about. I will just leave this trailer hooked up to this Land Rover. Probably will never come off again, dependent on what I do. Because now I've got a quad bike, I can go and have a look at fields. Not faster, but easier. Because it's easier to control. And it's also nicer to drive. And if I were to do a change of map as well, guys, changing the subject quickly, change of map, what map would you like to see done? if I change the maps, because I think when I get to episode 40 on here, maybe end the series, I don't know, or do less of it, do less of this map, because it's not as popular anymore as it was when I first got the map. So I think my first video's got 270 views, which was good. I was happy with that. I didn't get any subscribers from it, I don't think. Maybe got a few, but not many. It's a bad idea parking that there, because I need to get to the grass. And I will also just tip it in to the grass that I've cut into the pits. This is easier. Don't want cosplay. So then, how do we work this mower? B. Yeah, it works, that's good. Hasn't got the biggest tank in the world because we're already at 39%. Reckon you could get about 2,500 liters maybe grass. So I'm hoping for anyway. Well modelled this as well. I don't think they've changed anything from what it was like in FS 13. Tip this here, I think. Makes sense. Tip it right at the back. Kind of a nice feature that it kind of goes up and then tips out again. One thing I wish it did was cut a bit more grass off. Make it a bit lower cutting height. Nice mow of this. Kind of annoying Giants didn't actually put it back into the game. When they made 2015. Because it was a good feature. Because you don't want to be going around here, around places like that, with the big mower. It would be stupid. All these pieces grass, and you also can turn, I think, swap on or disable the pickup, so just like spread the grass out. Go over this anyway, it's not picking up any grass, but we can still go over it. To 8 miles an hour at some points, then it's a whopping 8 miles an hour in this. May also cut around them gates as well. In fact, why not? I'm gonna make a pile of grass just by that gate there, because I have the placeable heaps mod. So we put it down. I'm thinking about here, maybe. Then we can just dump grass there. Kind of good, just have a random grass pile for grass that we may need. The only bad thing, it takes a while to unload. I'm going to cut around the edge of this field as well, yeah. Well, not around the edge, but where the gate is. I think once I've done that, maybe to end up the episode. So then guys, like I said before, what map would you like if I changed the map that I use now? And why would you like that map? And that's it, end of the episode here. So, thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe if you're not subscribed already. But so far, I think, time of recording this, we're at 49. One subscriber off 50. So we're getting there, quite slowly. Multiplayer Monday starts on Monday. And Aldridge Farm will just be carrying on like it always does. Not like it always does. Like it will be doing. In July, basically. So guys, thanks for watching. See you next time. Goodbye.